हेलो एवरीवन, स्टैंडर्ड 10th सब्जेक्ट मैथ्स चैप्टर नंबर 2 पॉलीनोमियल्स पार्ट 2। इन प्रीवियस वन वी हैव सीन व्हाट इज पॉलीनोमियल्स, हाउ टू क्लासिफाई दैट पॉलीनोमियल्स। ओके, फर्स्ट वन इज बाय इट्स टर्म एंड द सेकंड वन इज बाय इट्स डिग्री। एंड वी हैव आल्सो सीन हाउ टू फाइंड अ जीरोस ऑफ दैट पॉलीनोमियल।
That are related to its coefficient only. So,
That is true for other polynomials also. Okay. Before that, we are going to see a geometrical meaning of the polynomials. Geometrical meaning of zeros of the polynomial. Now, we know that we have seen that our zeros of the linear polynomials are related to its coefficient only. Okay. Now, take one example. I am taking a polynomial, say P of x equals to 2y, 2x plus 3. Okay. In graphically, we are going to represent y equals to 2x plus 3. Y equals to 2x plus 3. Okay. Now, we plot one graph. Let me take x equals to, say, 0. X equals to 0. So, according to that, what is the value of my y? What is the value of my y? 3. If I am taking x equals to minus 1. X equals to minus 1. So, what is the value of my y? Plus 1. If I am taking a value x equals to minus 2, what is the value of my y? Minus 4 and plus 3. Then again minus 1. Okay. Now take one positive value, it will increase. Okay. If I am taking equals to 1, what is the value of my y? What is the value of my y? I am getting 5. Okay, I am checking for this 4 values only. So, here is my x dash, here is my y dash. Okay, so 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. Now, similarly, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Here we go till the 5 now. Minus 1, minus 2, minus 3, and minus 4. Okay. Now, minus 1, minus 2, minus 3, minus 4. Okay. Now, for x different value, we are going to plot graph. So, if my x is 0, see, over here my x and y, both are my zeros. So, for x equals to 0, the value of y is 3. It means somewhere over here. So, my x is 0 and y is 3. X is 0, y is 3. Now, minus 1 and 1. My x is minus 1 and y is positive 1. It means somewhere over here. Somewhere over here. So here is minus 1 and plus 1. Now x equals to minus 2. I am getting minus 1. X equals to minus 2. Getting minus 1. X equals to minus 2. Y equals to minus 1. X equals to plus 1. Y equals to 5. It means somewhere over here. X equals to 1. Y equals to 5. If you draw okay, I don't have scale, so it just so it cuts in the x-axis somewhere over here, and we have seen that zeros of a linear polynomial are related to its coefficient, and we know that what is the zeros of this polynomial? What are the zeros of this polynomial? Zeros of this polynomial are, so the zeros of this polynomial, zero of the polynomial, we know that zeros of the polynomial p of x, 2x plus 3 is nothing but the constant term divided with its coefficient of x, okay, the negative sign. So here I am getting the value of that polynomial over here, so zeros of the polynomial, okay. So we have seen that in somewhere between minus 1 and minus 2, my straight line cuts in the x-axis at which point? At this point. So this point is nothing but my zeros of a polynomial of that straight line, of that linear polynomial. So zeros of this polynomial is nothing but minus 3 by 2, 0. Minus 3 by 2, 0, okay, minus 3 by 2, 0. So, in general, we can say that the zeros of the polynomial, 2x plus 3, 2x plus 3 is a x-axis coordinate of a point where x-axis coordinate of a point where my graph y equals to 2x plus 3, y equals to 2x plus 3 intercept at x-axis. So in general, the zeros of this polynomial is nothing but where my point intersect in the x-axis, that is, that point is my zeros of that polynomial. So zeros of this polynomial is, this is my x-axis. So zeros of this polynomial always I'm getting on a x-axis only. So it intersects exactly how many points? This straight line intersects on a x-coordinate, how many points? Exactly one. So we can say that in a linear polynomial, the zeros of that polynomial has exactly one point, or say one zeros. Okay. So in general, we can say that a linear polynomial. In general, we can say that my linear polynomial ax plus b where a is not equals to 0. In a graph y equals to ax plus b intersect at x axis, intersect at x axis exactly 1 point. It exactly intersect 1 point. So we can say that a zeros of that polynomials, how many zeros? Exactly, if it's intersect exactly 1 point, it means the zeros of this linear polynomial is 1. So we can say, so linear polynomial has exactly 1 0, exactly 1 0. Okay, now let's take So, first we have seen for the linear, now quadratic polynomial. Quadratic polynomial. Consider, let my polynomial equals to x square minus 3x minus 4. Okay, now in a graphical representation, y equals to x square minus 3x minus 4. Now check a different values of x for a y. So my x and y. X and y. If I take x equals to 0, I mean minus 4. Yes. If we take x equals to minus 1. x equals to minus 1. So here I am getting 1 plus 3 and minus 4. So I am getting 0. 0. Now check for the say minus 2. Minus 2. So minus 2 is 4 plus 6 minus 4. I'm getting plus 6. Now check for the minimalistic value. Let's say 2. No, 1. So 1 is 1 minus 3 minus 4. Again I'm getting minus 6. Okay, minus 6. So just plot a graph, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 and 7. So again minus 1 till minus 1, minus 2 and minus 3, that's it now. Here we have to extend minus 6 till minus 6. Minus 1, minus 2, minus 3, minus 4, minus 5 and minus 6. Now प्लस वन टू थ्री फोर फाइव एंड सिक्स. नाउ एक्स इक्वल्स टू जीरो एंड वाई इक्वल्स टू माइनस फोर. इन दिस एक्स एक्सिस दिस इज माय जीरो जीरो. एक्स इक्वल्स टू जीरो एंड वाई इक्वल्स टू माइनस फोर. इट मीन्स ओवर somewhere over here x equals to 0 and y equals to minus 4. X equals to minus 1, y equals to 0. x equals to minus 1, y equals to 0. Okay, now x equals to minus 2, y equals to 6. Okay. So somewhere over here x equals to minus 2, y equals to 6. Now x equals to plus 1, y equals to minus 6. X equals to plus 1, y equals to minus 6. Now you can take one more few more things so that I'm taking few more set two. I'm two, so four minus six minus four, so that cancel minus six. Okay, now take 3 also, take 3 also, so the 9 minus 4, so minus 4, take 4 also, so take 4 also, so 16 minus 12 minus 4, 16 minus 12, so that cancels, that is 0. So now x equals to 2, y equals to minus 6. It means again somewhere over here, I'm writing 1 and minus 6. So again somewhere over here, 2 and minus 6. Okay, now 3 and minus 4. So somewhere over here, so 3 and minus 4. Okay, 4 and 0. 4 and 0. So my x equals to 4, y equals to 0. Now, if we connect all this point, if we connect all this point, okay, we get a parabola shape. We get a parabola shape. We get a parabola shape. And we have seen that what are the zeros of this polynomial? What are the zeros of the polynomial? At which point my y equals to 0, we know that is at that points are my zeros of that polynomial. So it, whenever my y equals to 0, my minus 1 and 4, minus 1 and 4 are zeros of this polynomial. It means simply a graph that intersect on the coordinate x-axis, that points are a zeros of that polynomial. So this graph exactly cut how many points? 2 points. So the zeros of this polynomials are, zeros of this polynomial are minus 1 and plus 4. Okay. Now, in quadratic equation, my graph either can be we know the general formula. We know the general formula of quadratic equation is ax square plus bx plus c, where a is not equals to 0. See, b and c can be 0, but my a cannot equals to 0. So the my value, it means the my graph totally depends upon the whatever the a is. If my a is greater than 0, then my graph should be upward. If my a is less than 0, then my graph should be a downwards parabola. Downwards parabola. This is a parabola. Okay, so this is the parabola. So the value of the graph totally depends upon this one. If a is positive, I'm getting upward open. If a is negative, then my graph is downwards open. Okay. So there are few more categories. Okay. If case one, let me give you this one. In quadratic equation, case one. We have seen that there in quadratic equation it contains at most how many roots? 2 roots. It means we can say, we have seen that this points are intersect at different point on a x-axis. So we can say that are two distinct point at, okay, in first step we can say either we can have a two distinct point on x-axis, two distinct points. Now case two, two distinct point of x-axis, two distinct point of x-axis. Now the second thing, so it can be like this way also. Okay, so similarly it cuts like that way only. Okay, so now the second thing, it exactly cut at only one point. It might be possible that it cuts exactly at one point like this way on the x-axis. So it can be like this way. So the only one point it cuts. So exactly one point. Okay, no other points. So it can be like this way also. It can be like this way also. It can be anything. But it exactly intersect on the x-axis at one point only. Okay. Now the third case says neither the graph no point on the x-axis, that graph is not cut on the x-axis. It means the graph should be like this way, or else this way. It can be anything. Okay, it cuts like this way. Okay, so no points on the x-axis. It means it does not cut on the x-axis. From all these three cases, we can say that in a quadratic polynomial, they have at most two zeros, at most they have at most 2 zeros, at most 2 zeros. Okay, it can be 1, it can be 2, it can be neither 1 neither 2, but it cannot be more than 2 points. Okay, so that's it for today. We are continuing in the next session.